Yeah, there you go. Yeah, this is for Campbell too. Let me get water. Now John at the bar is a friend of mine. He gets my drinks for free. And he's quick with a joke or to light up your smoke. But there's some place that he'd rather be. Hey guys, good morning. Oh, I need my charger. Dang. Good morning. This is 1.2. Well, the end of 1.1. Did you watch the first one? then you're gonna be kind of lost a little bit, Javi. Or you might catch up. Who knows? I'm on page 12. Page 12. I'm on page 12. Come get your love. Sounds good, buddy. Let's get this party started. I gotta wait for people. All right, morning, guys. Let's get this lesson out of the way. I'm on page 12.
All right. Morning, guys. Let's get this lesson.
Myself. Page 12. If you guys look at number 16, we really need to practice with these. We're going to do 16, 17, and 18, please. 16, 17, and 18. You got the chat ready? Alright, so the square root of 5, the square root of 5, again, if you do the square root of 5, we need to round it, because as you guys know, I don't know any number times any number to give you 5, because square root of 5 is not really a thing, so I need to find a way to find it. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to put the square root of 5 right here. I need to find a perfect square. I need a perfect square that goes after 5. Like a square root that you know the square root to. The more you volunteer, the more extra credit you guys get. I'm gonna mute myself on this one too. Oh, just remember, you're not using a calculator, so... I hope you're not using one. Can I get a perfect square after the square root of 5? A square root after 5. The one after is going to be 9. The one before is going to be the square root of 4. The square root of 4 is 2. And the square root of 9 is 3. So, I'm going to put... The number between 2 and 3 is 2.5. So over here is 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.6, 2.7, 2.8, and then finally 2.9. If 4 comes right after 5, if the square root of 4 is right here, and then comes 5, and then comes 6, and then comes 7, and then comes 8, the square root of 5, what do you guys think it's going to be? The square root of 5. Yeah, I would say the square root of 5 is going to be somewhere around 2.1 or 2.2. Somewhere around there. Somewhere around there. I would say 2.1, 2.2 would be an answer. All right. I'm going to do the square root of 3. Without me even doing the square root of 3, I know the square root of 4 is 2. And I know the square root of 3 comes right before it. What do you guys think the square root of 3 is going to be? Without me doing the number line, what do you guys think it's going to be? Oh, sorry, hang on. Let me go back. Why 9? There is no square root of 6. Nothing times nothing is going to give you 6. Because it has to be the same number multiplied by itself. The square root of 7, there is no square root of 7. Square root of 8, there is no square root of 8. And then the square root of 9. Oh, that one you know for sure is going to be 3. Because 3 times 3 is 9. You have to find a perfect square after and the perfect square before. I got to blow my nose. Too much allergies.
Hey, Okay, so you need to find two perfect squares, one after and one before, so that way you can make like a little number line, and that way you can tell which number the square root of 5 is closest to. It's really close to the square root of 4, and the number right after the square root of 4 is square root of 5. So the number right after 2 is 2.1, and then it comes 2.2. So it kind of goes in like a little order. Well, it's confusing because you missed the first part of the lesson. All right, and then I went back to the square root of 3. I know the square root of 4 is 2. The number right before, what number comes right before 2? What decimal comes right before 2? What decimal comes right before 2? Just like the number that comes right before 4 is 3. What number comes right before 2? 1.9, correct. So this one should be about 1.9. If you give me 1.8, I'll take that as an answer also. And if you want to be pushing the limit, I'll even take 1.7. I'll take those as an answer. Then finally, you have the square root of 10. The square root of 10. The closest square root will be the square root of 9. The number right after 9 is 10. The square root of 9 is 3. So this number has to be what? What would probably be the square root of 10? Yeah, the number right after 9 is 10. So the number right after 3 is going to be 3.1. I'd even take 3.2 as an answer. I'll take either or as an answer. Okay. Let's get on to the other parts so I can finish this lesson. And then I'll come back and do a couple more of these. I don't need to classify anything. Skipping this. This was a fun lesson too. Okay. Ordering real numbers. I am on page 21. Page 21. I'm on page 21. Page 21. Next week. Quiz is next week. All you gotta do is just go back and watch the first lesson. That's it. You didn't miss much. You just gotta go back and watch it, because right now you're just seeing a whole bunch of new stuff, like stuff that I've taught you don't even know what I'm even saying. But all right, here we go. I missed this lesson. I need to find the square root of 3 plus 5, and then 3 plus the square root of 5. I gotta see which one's bigger. Let me maximize this a little bit too. Okay, what did we say the square root of 3 was? We just did a little while ago. I know the square root of 4 is 2, so the square root of 3 comes right before. What number comes right before 2? Just like the number that comes right before 4 is 3. What number comes right before 2? I'll let you know by the end of this week what day it's going to be on. All right, so I know this one's going to be, let me scratch this out, let me put 1.9 plus 5. How much is 1.9 plus 5? 1.9 plus 5. How much is 1.9 plus 5? Okay, so this one's going to be 6.9. Put a big circle. And then I got to do the square root of 5. I know the square root of 4 is 2. So the number that comes right after the square root of 4 is 5. So the number that comes right after this one, I'd say this one's probably going to be like 2.1. So 3 plus 2.1 is going to be 5.1. Which way does the fire-breathing shark eat it? Does it eat the 6.9 or does it eat the 5.1? The fire-breathing shark. Which side of numbers does it eat? Yeah, 2.1, 2.2 is fine. No matter which one you added up, Kata, it won't really matter. There'll be a huge difference between them most of the time. So it eats to the left. If you guys, some of you guys were figuring out how to do it. The fire Breathing shark eats the 6.9. The 6.9 is the one that gets eaten. Okay. Let's do a couple more of these, and we are done with this lesson. And if you want to meet me on Zoom after, some of you guys that are missed the lesson or some of you guys that need help, I can help you guys. Okay? Let's do a couple more of these. Let's do 3 and 4 on the bottom. Okay. Square root of 2. The square root of 2. I know the square root of 4 is 2. So then it comes 3. Then it comes 2. And then comes 1. So this number has to be, the square root of 1 is 1. So I know this number has to be in between 1 and 2. What do you guys think the square root of 2 is going to be? Go for it, Darren. This video will be up by the time you finish that one. And let me know if you need me at all. Just text me, okay? Some of you guys are using a calculator, so y'all tripping. All right, I'll say 1 point. I'll meet you guys in the middle. Some of you guys say 1.2. Some of you guys say 1.5. I'll do 1.2. I don't think it really makes a difference. All right. 1.2 plus 4. That gives you 5.2. Okay, so 5.2. And then you have 2 plus 4. Oh, this one's easy. The square root of 4 is 2. So 2 plus 2 is 4. Which way does the fire-breathing shark eat? To the left or to the right? You can type in left, you can type in right, or you can just type in the symbol if you can find it on your computer. If you guys find it, it's shift. And then it's right next to the question mark and the M. It eats the 5.2. Come and get your love, come and get your love, come and get your love now. It eats that one right there. Oh, gotta give it a spin. It eats the 5.2. So just remember, you'll have to draw your fire-breathing sharks on the paper, just like you guys did in elementary school. Remember elementary school when you guys were drawing the fire-breathing sharks? Okay. Number 4 is all yours, guys. Number 4 is all yours. And this one's like cake. Giving out answers here. I mean, I'm giving out extra credit here. Campbell's class, you're included in this. Square root of 12, I'd say, is probably like 3.4, 3.5, I guess. And 3.5 plus 6 is going to be 9.5. And then you have the square root of 6, which is 2.5, I'd say. I guess it doesn't really matter. Oh, 12 is already bigger. 12 is already bigger than 9.5. So the fire-breathing shark... Oh, I hate drawing the fire-breathing sharks going this way. They don't look as mean. I got it. Sebastian, Matthew, and Ali, if you give me your name, I'll tell Mr. Campbell to give you extra credit. Matthew and Sebastian, remind me to give you 2 extra credit points for your next test. The test coming up. Ali, if you give me your name, I can tell Campbell to put it on for you. Shark boy moments? What are you talking about? You guys learned that fire-breathing shark thing in elementary school, right? Like the greater than or equal to? Right? You guys learned that in elementary school? The fire-breathing sharks thing? Okay, I'll tell Campbell, so. What period? Alligator? What alligator? You guys did not learn the fire-breathing shark or the fire-breathing mermaid in elementary school? What? What's wrong with you guys? What elementary school was this? Alligator? What? So let me get this straight. Your teachers in elementary school drew this? I guess, whatever. I don't even know how to draw an alligator. How do you even draw an alligator? Like this? What? Okay, it's a shark. It's a fire-breathing shark. Let's get this straight, okay? I don't care who you had in elementary school. It's always been a fire-breathing shark, okay? Yeah, there's also a fire-breathing mermaid if you were in advanced, you know, in elementary school. Okay. It's not an alligator. Nobody learned an alligator. Okay. We need to order these in order from least to greatest. This is the last part of this lesson, the last and final part. We need to order these from least to greatest. So the first thing I need to do is I need to find all these numbers. I need to find out all these numbers. The square root of 5... I know the square root of 4 is 2. The square root of 5 comes right after. I would say that this one's going to be about 2.1. The square root of 3, I know, comes right before the square root of 4. So I would say this one's going to be the number. What's the number right before 2 again? Okay, it's an alley. It's a shark, okay? It's a fire-breathing shark. All right, and I would say this one's about 1.9, somebody said. Okay. I'm going to put 2.5 right here because this one's easy. 2.5 is right here, so I'll just put 2.5. Then I got 1.9, which is going to be right... I'll put the square root of 3 like right over here because it's going to be this 1.9 like you guys said. And then I have the square root of 5, which is 2.1. So I'd put it right over here. If I had to put them in order, it's going to be the square root of 3, the square root of 5, and then comes 2.5. I'll let you guys try some by yourselves. We'll do one more. I'll let you guys try it by yourself, and then we'll finish the lesson. And then I'll give you the last little bit of extra credit. And then finally, I have pi to the second power. How much is pi again? How much is pi? How much is pi? Because I got to multiply pi times pi. Okay, so I got 3.14 times 3.14. Oh boy, this is a long one. This gives you 16, 4, 5, 12, 4, 1, 3, 0, 0, 12, 3, 4, 9. 6, 9, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9. There's 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Woof. Okay, so this one's 9.9. Woo! No, you were doing 3.14 times 2. You have to do 3.14 times 3.14. Okay, so I know 10 is going to be right here. And the square root of 75. Ooh, that's a tough one. I know the square root of 81 is 9. I know the square root of 64 is 8. What do you guys think the square root of 75 would be? It's pretty smack in the middle, both of those numbers. But it's a little bit closer to 81. It's 6 away from 81. And it's 9 away from 64. So it's not right in the middle. It's a little bit closer to 81. What do you guys think the square root of 75 would be? Sure, 8.6, 8.7, 8.5 I'll even take. I don't think it really matters. It's in the 8s, right? So it doesn't really matter. It's going to be the least no matter what. So I guess that the square root of 75 comes first. Then comes pi squared. And then comes 10. Okay, I'll give you guys one to try by yourself. I'll hand out the last little bit of extra credit. I'll go over anything. If you guys want to stay, I'll go over anything you guys need. And the last one will be this one right over here. Right over here. Number 7 is all yours, guys. I'll give out the last little bit of extra credit, please. And then you don't have to see my ugly face in the mic anymore. Or my unbrushed teeth. See? Don't they have gunk in them? Let's change the names around. Let's put... This guy's gonna be Sebastian. This girl is gonna be, of course, Kata. This one's gonna be, let's do Sal. And this one's gonna be LaShonda. Let's change her to... Let's change LaShonda to Nickelback. You gotta put it from greatest to least. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, true. Greatest to least. Give me an extra credit. Gonna get your love. Whoa. See, the problem is, Daniel, if you put 3.5, I'm not going to know which one it is. And if you put that 3.3 or whatever repeating, I don't know which one that is. You have to put the actual original ones on HRW and on your test. If you put the names, I don't think you're going to see the names. Guys, it says from greatest to least. Read the question. It says from greatest to least. You guys are putting it over from least to greatest. I don't know which one 3.333333 is. I don't know what 3.1 is. I don't know what those are. You have to put the original ones. If I do 10, 10 falls into the box. 5, 10 over 3. And I have Kata. Kata has more hair on her left side of her head. She has like one strand over here. If she cuts down the tree, 10 falls into the box. So 10 goes inside the box. 3 stays on the outside. 3 goes into 10 three times. This is 3.3 repeating. And the square root of 10 is going to be, I know the square root of 9 is 3, so the square root of 10 should be like, the number right after 9 is 10, so the number right after 3 is going to be 3.1. Greatest to least. Oh, 1 half. I know it's 3.5. That one's easy. Greatest to least. So first comes 3 and 1 half. Sal, you're first, dude. And then comes Kata. And then comes Sebastian. I'll just put Seabass. And then comes finally the greatest rock band in the entire world. Oops, that's not what I meant to put. I'm breaking my own rule over here. 10 over 3. Seabass. And then finally comes the greatest rock band in the whole world. Nickelback. Extra credit right there goes to who's first? Who's about first, second? Let me go with. All right, Danilo, you can get it again. Fine. And Gabby Gigante, both of you guys get the final ones. Danilo and Gabby Gigante. Okay, there goes your answer. If you guys don't need me, have a great day. If somebody wants to type in what they want me to go over one last time, any little tiny part of this lesson, I don't mind. Please ask away. Yeah, you always put your hair to the left. You always like part it to the left. You never really do that middle thing. Is there anything you guys need me to go over? Your HRW will be up in like 5 minutes. Is there anything you need me to go over? Yep, your homework is going to be on HRW. I'm going to put it up in like 5 minutes as soon as I... Okay, explain the shark thingy. Okay, so back in elementary school, you guys should have learned that, you know, greater than or less than or equal to, whatever it is, you know, all that stuff right there. Okay, so then there's sharks. Because sharks eat things, duh. It's easy. Sharks eat, you know, humans, animals, fish. They eat everything. They're the king of the sea, you know? So, shark eats things. Yes, it's another HRW. Yes, you remind me about your extra credit when you finish your test. I will put it in. Your HRW will be up in like 5 minutes. Okay, it's not alligators. It's not. Okay, let's just get that out of the way, okay? There's no such thing as an alligator eating something. That doesn't make any sense. Nobody even knows how to draw an alligator. Like, what teacher have you ever had in the past draw an alligator eating a number? Like, what teacher? What? Explain to me. Which part of the beginning? It's due on Sunday. All your stuff is always due on Sunday. Which part of the beginning? Because I can't just restart the whole lesson, but I'll go over a certain part if you need me to. Which part? Yeah, but have you ever drawn an alligator eating the numbers? That's the real question. Like, Matthew, do me a favor. Do number one on paper and then send me a picture of it with the alligator eating because I don't believe it. That's impossible. You can't do it. The fire, you guys ain't ready for the fire-breathing mermaid. Y'all ain't ready. It's not, what alligators, bro? There's no alligators. Matthew, do it. Do number one on paper, send me a picture of it, and let me see the alligator. You can't draw an alligator. No teacher has ever drawn an alligator. They always just do this. And if you had one of the best teachers in the world, then they would have drawn the fire-breathing shark because they had the time to do it. But they only did this. Nobody draws an alligator. Like, I don't get it. Like, how do you draw an alligator? Doesn't make any sense. Why gator? Oh, my God. Okay, because you guys went to Gator Run. That's probably what it is. That's probably what it is. You guys went to Gator Run. Okay, so when you find out the square roots of numbers. That's what it is. You guys want the Gator Run. That's all it is. No wonder. I figured it out. I got to the bottom of it. What teeth? Then it looks like Pac-Man with a mouth. Alright. So I have... Actually, I don't like these right here. That's what it is. I figured it out. No wonder. That's not true. Just because you're my mom doesn't mean I gotta believe you. That doesn't mean anything. Your friend from Manatee definitely learned fire-breathing sharks. That's for sure. It's a manatee. Sharks eat manatees. Duh. Duh. It's easy money. Alright. So, the square root of 5. Alright, send me a picture of it. The square root of 5. I know the square root of 5 doesn't really have a number. It doesn't have an answer. There is no square root of 5. There's no perfect square root of 5. So, I gotta find a perfect square that comes after and before. A perfect square that comes after is the square root of 9. And a perfect square that comes before is 5 and then 4. So this one's going to be 2. And this one's, I got to make this nice and long. So this one's going to be 3. The square root of 9 is 3. And the square root of 4 is 2. And I know right in the middle of 2 and 3 is going to be 2.5. This is the square root of 4. This is the square root of 9. So I'm going to fill in this whole number line. I'm going to try to space it out as best as I can. Square root of 5. Square root of 6. Square root of 7, and then finally square root of 8. And if I follow the number pattern, 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.6, 2.7, 2.8, and then finally 2.9. Kyle, if you had to say which one is the square root of 5, if you make this number line every single time, you won't have a problem. But Kyle, if you had to say the square root of 5, what number do you think it's going to be? All you guys took an L right now about that fire-breathing shark. All you guys just took an L. Kyle, what do you think the square root of 5 is? Kind of like if you draw the number line and you just, like, you know, put an arrow straight down. Perfect. 2.2. Now, Kyle, last and final question. The square root of 10. This one right over here. The square root of 10. The one that comes right before the square root of 10 is the square root of 9, which is 3. The number right after 9 is 10. So the number right after 3 is... But remember, you got to give me a decimal because the square root of 10 is not 4. So what number comes right after 3? Like, coming with decimals. Starting with decimals now. The number right after 9 is 10. So the number right after 3 is going to be 3.1. Yeah. All right. Guys, have a great day. If you need me, just text me. I'll be on Zoom. If anything, you guys know I always go on Zoom right after. So I'll see you guys on Zoom. All right. Have a great day. And all you guys took an L, fire breathing sharks. You already know.